Hey everybody, today I'm going to show you how to add various questions from PearDeck AddOn into your Google Slides presentation to make it more interactive. So if you haven't already installed the PearDeck AddOn, check out my other video on how to do that. But for now, let's open up the PearDeck AddOn by either clicking on the PearDeck button right here, or if you don't have that button, if you click on Add-ons, you can come down to PearDeck and open PearDeck AddOn here. So, real quick survey of the PearDeck AddOn is you have several different question types that you can ask. So I've got here a presentation about whether or not you force out or tag out a runner in baseball or softball or wiffle ball or even kickball. So what I want to do is I want to show you how to add the various question types. So for the first slide, what I want to do is I want to ask them just some basic questions. How many players are on a standard baseball team? So I can ask a question by using the number question type. And if I click on number, it'll add it to my question type. And then all I have to do is make sure that I add some sort of prompt to the page so that students know that they can, that they have to add a question. So I'll click on the text box here and I'll just draw a text box. Go ahead and center that. Okay, so now I've got the question. How many baseball defensive players on the baseball field at one time? Over the question mark. So that'll be my first question.
Okay, so let's take a look and see what this looks like from the student perspective. So what I want to do first is I want to make sure that my PearDeck is turned on. And when the PearDeck menu opens, what we want to do to check it from the student point of view is to click the button that says Start Lesson. It'll pop open the screen and you have a choice to do it either in student pace mode or instructor pace activity. So because we're in continuity of learning, we're going to select student pace so that the students can do this at their own pace, at their own time. The instructor pace would assume that students are meeting either live and in person or live on a virtual meeting, which they are. We're not going to assume that. So just got to make sure I connect with my Google account. And then it will bring up this launching screen. And so the teacher dashboard is a great tool to use if you've got the premium edition, which all FCPS teachers do. This works fantastically if you're doing it live and in person. So check out my other videos about that. But for now, we're just going to skip this and click Got It. And it brings us up to the student pace mode. What we want to do is we want to copy this link that we're going to give to the students through Schoology. And then I'm going to go ahead and I can click go to teacher dashboard if I want. This allows me to see the responses, but that's not what we're looking at today. So I've got here my son's FCPS Google account. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to just paste and go to that link that I shared. I'm going to log in with his Google information for school. And because we're in self-paced mode, at the bottom of the screen, he has the navigation buttons. So the number question that I have, we just put in there is how many defensive players on the baseball field one time? And so students can either type the number or they can use these arrows to submit their numbers. And so their number is automatically submitted. So when they go to the next slide, it is recorded for you and then they can move on to the next question.